Last time on Babs Bear Talk.
Okay. Hey guys, it's Saturday morning, January the 7th, and I'm doing my succotash thing, but instead of doing it with brown rice like I did for the fast series, I am doing it with whole grain pasta. This is gonna be lunch and dinner today for me. And I guess for Joe too, because he eats whatever I take with me to the shop. So here's the finished product, guys. A wonderful healthy dish. Joe is where he's usually at in the morning, playing around on Facebook. Or like when these people say Fastbook. I forgot to show you guys that the breakfast is one of those fruit smoothies with the spinach. Just made it into work, guys. Well, not work, the shop. And the people next door had all the parking spots taken. So we had to like knock on the door and get them to move from our number one spot. That's so, that would have been so annoying if we had to stay here. So let's go through this rubble, okay? I have to go through these old files and just kind of tear them up, destroy them. That's going to be my job today. Anything that Joe didn't take to the dump yesterday, he's going to take today in Jory's truck. He's coming in a little bit. This machine is still here. We don't know if those people are going to buy it or not. But we're not taking it home. So if they don't buy it, we'll junk it. The forklift's going to get picked up at 8:30. It's 8:15 now. Serge and them started early because they got a big baby shower later on today that they're going to be partying. And all this is gonna go to the dump, and Joshua doesn't have to go to the dump today because Jory's gonna go. Everybody gets a turn, huh, babe? Everybody gets a turn to go to the dump. Everybody gets one turn to go to the dump, except for me. I don't want to go smell no trash, huh, baby? You got me spoiled, huh? You don't carry this one today to in a Jory truck? This thing right here.
Yeah.
The vice. Huh?
This.
If it works, keep it. You can never tell if Jada could use it. We don't use blow dryers at the house, but Joe uses blow dryers here to make the screens. You know, sometimes, guys, I debate whether or not to leave my emotional outbursts, aka crying, in the vlogs. But I don't do them often. And I think if they make sense in the storyline, I'll keep them in. Because yesterday, I didn't even know those tears were going to come yesterday. I didn't think I was going to feel that way when the machine left. And if I could try to explain it a little bit, when Joe got that machine, it was in rubble. He took 2 years of my tax returns to fix that machine in the garage. Took up half my garage. You're going to hear a lot of noise today. And then finally he lost his job, and I was the one that decided to open this business because Joe was so petrified after he lost his job. It took us $60,000 to open this business, okay? And we opened, and the guy that bought the big machine was the first one to give us 2 customers. Didn't even know us, just wanted to be kind. And again, what he did right here at the end, just wanted to be kind. He doesn't need the machine. And it just really hit me yesterday. I could have lamented on all the people that didn't come through for me, even friends that says you can call me if you need to talk. And when you call them, they send a phone call to voicemail. I could have lamented on that, but I decided not to. What I really cried about was a little bit of frustration, a little bit of sadness, because Sugar, you are right, it is a loss. And it's not like we're walking out of this business with money. We're walking out of this business broke, and we need for these machines to sell in order to have money to do the next business. And I mean, letting Sergio have the compressor on payments, that's gonna pinch us, because we really needed that money lump sum, you know? And then my other friend that's in the industry said, I was gonna buy the compressor, well, he didn't speak up quick enough, and he would have paid me the whole money up front. But I still think it went to the right person, because Serge is going to do that car business with us. He's going to be fixing our cars. He's going to help us find sales for the cars and stuff like that, you know? So I think it went to the right place. It's a seed sown in good soil. Speaking of seed, Jen, if you're watching my vlogs, baby girl, thank you for that donation that you gave to my PayPal. That means you are awesome. I'm going to give you your shout out in the next video and put you on my board, girl. Ooh, thank you. I got to go find you on my Facebook. Yeah, so I'm not feeling sad today. Oh, back to the machine. We brought the machine here on a flatbed truck like that. And I remember when we put it in this building, I was so scared. Because I was like, Joe, we did all this and now we don't have no customers. And that machine served us well for 15 years. That machine is 45 years old, y'all. I'm lucky if I can get anything out of that machine, I'm telling you, money-wise. And I think something happened to me when I saw the machine leave the same way it came. It just felt like a funeral, you know? It just felt like it was going to a funeral procession, though. I was like, wow. And then I get home, and you don't even want to see the garage. It is a mess. It makes me weep. I can't even get to my plates and my cups and stuff to do my YouTube. But when this rain stops, we're going to have to go in there and clean up the garage. And I don't want the machine to set into any place comfortable. Because if it's set in someplace comfortable, Joe will not sell it. He'll sit there and just let it sit there. No. I got to make sure I make a lot of phone calls to get that machine sold for whatever we can get.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. What?
You gotta lift up the...
It's up
the fork.
Open the door. Open the door.
Right there.
You're gonna fall off of that, Joe?
Yeah. Nah, pull it up.
Oh, he's gonna pull it? Okay. That's smart. These guys came prepared. I'm gonna teach Joe how to plait this wire the right way for the TV industry. Here, Joe, show me the plait the wire. You're drop this by the way, you
can. I can't pop this door, look at it.
You're focused on it?
Oh,
that doesn't make me feel as sad as when the machine left. All right, so you plug it in, right, to each other, and then you start like this. Make a circle. So you want to put this through here, right, to make that first loop, and then from there just do this. I had to do this when I was taking television broadcasting, and they grade you on this crap. And the boys couldn't get it at all, but the girls got it.
Me? I still can't do it.
So you plait it like this, because what's supposed to happen, so it gets shorter, but what happens when you go on your set, right, for your TV thing, you're supposed to pop it out like that, and just shake it, see?
Oh, you're smart.
And it shakes right now. You can have your wire and stuff.
Hey, are you a Greenwich? You're
smart. I don't have that. I bought that name for $13 30 years ago. You got it?
Yeah.
Huh? You got it?
Yeah.
Alright, so make a fluffy thing. Jory's here.
Fluffy.
Three boxes, oh, all these boxes right here? Okay, so we're gonna have to find out that place by the airport then, right? Going to the dump one more time, guys. I could continue that for a while, no? Let me see. Here's Lazarus, guys. Leave it right here. Because when we sell it, they could just throw it out the same way. So I'm going to sweep here. And then you put back everything that was there. Okay? Because we're not using half the stuff that was there anyways. And then... Huh? And then we're going to have a path here. Okay? We're going to have a path here to come out the garage. Because I need to get to my stuff over there to do my show. You got me?
I got you, but mine is whatever.
Because there's the t-shirt press is not going to stay out there. So this is the best we can do right now. This is 24-hour Jory. See up there on the sign? This is his gym when he can't go to the gym. So the screen making machine is here for the legs. The pedal machine is there. We have to stand the treadmill up. This is a small machine. Then Lazarus is still here. And everything's back in its place. I don't know why Joe moved everything when I wasn't here yesterday, because it didn't make any sense to me. But I think he wanted to put the machine here. But if he does that, all these ones are going to have to be in front of it. And then we'll never sell this machine. This machine got to go. You know what I mean, honey? This got to go next week. We're going to work hard on this, all right? Find these people that buy and sell machines and just sell it. Yup. So I can get back over there for my crackeries. Who says crackeries anymore? Showing my age, huh? I've had this piano since I was 16. Jada doesn't want to get rid of it. But this is all my stuff that I use for YouTube covered up under there. Now it's time to eat, babe. It's time to eat. I'm hungry. So Joe cooked the food and he didn't even wait for me.
Wow.
This is a little fish stew thing that he likes to make. So I'm eating with brown rice and plantain, okra, and salmon. Wenza loves fish, so she's like dogging us. It's the end of the day on day 4. You guys know I'm doing a series, right? I'm counting down to the closure of the business. We have to give back the keys on Thursday the 12th. I want to give back the keys by Tuesday the 10th. Honestly, it's not my intention to stay in these people's building any longer than I have to. I would rather give them the key earlier in the month so they can go in there and paint and do the floor and everything, and they can rent it out for like February 1st. I don't want to like abuse these people, right? Even though I don't like that lady, I am still classy when it comes to business. So today is January the 7th. It's 7 months since mommy passed away. And I wonder if maybe that's why I was so emotional yesterday. I didn't even realize the date till my sister told me. And then I sat there and thought about it and go, oh my God, maybe that's why I was so emotional. Right now it's after 5 in the evening and I want to get this vlog edited early so I can get it up early for you guys. I really appreciate the fact that you guys don't complain about how late I get the vlogs up. I do try start to edit them like at 6 in the evening when I'm doing the daily vlogs. And I'm done like around 9, 10 at night. And I edit faster than that, but when I say I'm done, it's saved. And then I recheck it and all these things. And then the upload. Oh my goodness, the upload takes so long. Joshua has to go by here like at midnight and check it. And then if it's done, he closes off my computer and then it's out for you guys to see. So on one of the vlogs a while back, I usually put, when I say last time on Bab's Bear Talk, I usually put the word previously. That word didn't even get spelled out in it. You know, I spelled it out, but sometimes it glitches and you guys didn't even complain. You guys are so cool. So the highs and lows that I went through yesterday, a lot of good came out of it, honestly, because when Bernardo didn't bring the trailer, I was kind of upset at first. Then I realized Joel couldn't really manipulate that trailer. You know, so I'm glad he just got the use of the truck. So that worked out. When Serger's worker Toby's son flaked out on us, I was kind of upset. But then I realized Chavez was the best person to bring that machine home because he knew how to wind it up on that thing and just kind of swooped it into the garage where it's at right now. As soon as we're done completely and we give back the keys, we're going to hit everybody hard with buying those machines. I don't want those machines to sit there too long. Even if I don't end up getting what I hope to get out of them, I'm going to have to let them go because it's taking up space in the garage and I could translate it into money that we can go in and, you know, buy the next car and go from there. I have a really good setup with Sergio because him being a mechanic and being so trustworthy, he knows a lot of customers who wants to buy cars. So I told him I'll give him like a finder's fee for every car that he helps me sell. Of course, he's going to fix the cars when we buy them. So I'm really optimistic about that. So you guys be praying on that for me, okay? As far as my YouTube goes, the videos that I put up with the fast are doing so well. The breakfast one had 1.3, you know, 1,000 views already. So 1,380, I think, somewhere thereabouts. I jumped past 29,000 subscribers, which is awesome for me. You know, I look at other YouTubers that grow quickly, and I wish I could grow quickly like them, but I don't know what else to do, you know, to grow quickly. I mean, you have to have a certain group of people backing you. You know what I mean? Like, for instance, Black Americans have Black Americans backing them. Mexicans have Mexicans backing them. Asians have Asians backing them. Italians have Italians backing them. And I think that's how it works. Unfortunately, Belizeans, you know, even though I have a lot of good Belizeans backing me, a lot of them don't. I mean, look at that one lady that's supposed to be a friend of the family that got PO'd because I spoke out against her god, Donald Trump. And I didn't even say nothing hateful. You know, I'm never going to say nothing hateful up here. Are you kidding? They're not going to use my words to choke me with it. But she got mad, and not only did she stop watching, but she made sure she called every family member and told them not to watch. What a witch with a capital B. That's what she is, you know? So, Josh was like, yeah, we need to get one group of people that are just going to back you. And when I do Mexican food, the Mexicans back me hard. Go look at my Mexican tamales video. It has a lot of views. That's the video that makes me the most money every month. I'm Belizean and Mexican tamales makes me money. You know, so I think it makes like $37, $40 a month. The rest of it just makes, you know, peanuts and then it adds up. So it's like, yeah, I'm going to start doing more Mexican food. Forget this. So, but anyways, everybody's home right now. Joe's sleeping on the couch. He is so exhausted physically. You guys saw him drive that forklift on that ramp. I was so scared for my baby. And those guys came and they were like, one of them could drive the forklift. You could see he knows what he was doing. And when he got to the ramp, he goes, you drive it. I was like, oh my God, my poor baby. He's 59 years old. He can't be falling off this forklift. Sergio and them were watching with their mouths open. So he's physically exhausted right now. Emotionally, he's in a good space because his two important machines are out of there. As far as that dryer, that tunnel dryer is concerned, I really hope somebody will step up to the plate and pay me a few hundred dollars for it. If not, I don't know what I'm going to do with it because I don't know who I'm going to give it to. I don't want to give it to the guys that came because they offered me money for it. And they've been really, really rude about the way they conduct business. And so I would never give it to them. I would chop it up into pieces first and have somebody sell it for scrap than to give it to them. That's how I feel. Honestly, that's how I feel right now. So as usual, as you go through trials and tribulations in life, you're going to find out that people that you think are going to be there for you are usually not. And people that you don't even know will step out for you. And I think that was part of my emotional state yesterday too, because I was like, wow, you know, this is so cool. I mean, when it comes to Bernardo, we've known him since 2002. Our kids grew up together. He was always, his wife and kids were always in my shop. We used to be in the back together. I was in 415, Bernardo was in 417, so we're close together. And the kids would play together. We'd go to his house for barbecues and, you know, baptisms and birthday parties. And they would come to my house for every one of Jada's birthday parties. We were so close. And throughout the years, he just started to, like, turn into somebody that's stingy. He's not evil, you know, just stingy. And then Sergio moved in there, and I've never been to Sergio's house. I don't even know what his wife looks like. I don't know what his children look like. I just know Sergio. And he's always been respectful and, you know, decent and generous to us. And, you know, when he came in and he started to tell us different people back there that, use him and abuse him and, you know, use him for his skills and stuff. We didn't even know that was going on, you know, and so, and when I told him, you know, different people that I thought were witches with capital B's back there, then he was like, oh my God, you hate the same people I hate. And it's not hate, it's more like dislike. And so, yeah, you know, it was really, really a rough day for me yesterday, and I thank you guys for being there for me, I really do. I'm not one of these vloggers. I always tell you guys, I don't make up content, and some content that I could share with you that would get me to where I need to get to as a vlogger, I would not share because it would embarrass, you know, a friend or a family member, so I would not do that. But I'm so glad to have some of your phone numbers as deep, deep friendship today. I was able to talk to Shanika. I talked to Helen this week, and of course, Sandra. I talked to Sandra often, and you guys have so been there for me, and Sugar, you know, you've been here for me right here on this page and privately through Facebook. And Sam, you know, Sam, you made me laugh so hard the other day when you were talking about the Deep South and the snow. I hope you guys are okay in the snow. And I was laughing so hard I was wheezing. And Joe says, tell Sam to stop because he's going to make you have to go to the emergency room. But it was so funny because it just reminds me of Belizeans when the hurricanes are coming and you go get that Spam and that corned beef though. And all that bread, and you have to move to the upper level, and you know you can't stay downstairs in the first floor, and yada yada. So, it was really cool, you know, to be talking with you on Facebook that day. Yeah, so I think you guys have been brought up on everything for today. I want to go ahead and get this vlog edited and uploaded before it's too late. I'm gonna go to bed early today. I think we're gonna go to the shop again tomorrow. We're not gonna go to dump again because they're not open on Sunday. And whatever else we have to dump, we're just gonna bring here and call the trash company and tell them send an extra truck out on Thursday when they pick up my regular trash and pick up 5 bulky items. You can do that twice a year. You can pick, call them to pick up 5 bulky items twice a year. So that's what we might end up doing with those couches if somebody doesn't come get it. The dryer, we might have to end up chopping that into pieces. We might have to end up murdering that. So I told Joe today, I love Tanya Tucker, T-A-N. And I was singing a song of hers in my brain today, Two Sparrows in a Hurricane. And I told Joe, that's how I felt this morning because it was raining. We're in there, it's cold, we're getting everything done. And I said, I feel like we're two sparrows in a hurricane. What is it? Lila's telling me something. I'm going to go read what you said, Lila. Yeah, guys, so I will see you guys tomorrow, okay? Tomorrow will be day three, and I didn't shed a tear today. I've been good today, and I'm grateful that Joshua came on last night and finished up the vlog for me. He's such a sweet boy. So I'll see you guys tomorrow, okay? Keep me in your prayers just as I keep you in my prayers. I lift you guys up unceasingly. I'm praying all day long. And I call your names out to God all day long so that you can receive what you need from him and what you desire. So I just ask you to do the same for me because I really do feel it when you're praying and I receive your prayers all day long. I receive every word you guys speak over me. When you tell me something positive that's going to happen for me, I receive it as prophecy. As prophecy, okay? Now, I'm glad that you guys had fun a couple of vlogs back when we were talking the little superstitions. And I've been like racking my brain to remember some more of the crazy superstitions that we have. So maybe tomorrow's vlog, you know, I'll include some more there, okay? And these are meant for fun, all right? These are not meant to harm anybody or whatever. These are meant for fun. And if you guys have superstitions you want to share with me, Sam, thanks for sharing the one about your dad and the trash. I have another one that with the soft spot on the baby's head. Tomorrow, okay? I love you guys.
When the red button is on?
Yeah.
Okay
guys, see, I'm doing it.
This is very
ready. He doesn't want to go back on the boat. Splash.
Splash?
Yeah.